fullers tonight, the four-wheel drives and the two-wheel drives. The track's in great shape, and the modifieds are here, the 6,200-pound and the 7,200-pound two-wheel drives. I tell you what, Bob, that should be a great class. I can't call a winner. It's going to be good.
And we have the battle of the monster trucks.
Monster truck action looks great. Bigfoot's on hand. The loser goes out. The winner comes back for another round until we have a champion tonight. And the guys have got the guns loaded. They're looking for the Bigfoot truck, and it should be very, very exciting monster truck action tonight.
Sounds like a great show, so stay with us. The Ford Budweiser United States Hot Rod Association Motorsports Extravaganza. Brought to you by Budweiser, the genuine article. Beats wood age for that clean, crisp taste that makes Budweiser the king of beers. For all you do, this Bud's for you.
Boy,
Galloway back with you here at the Budweiser United States Hot Rod Association Motorsports Extravaganza. You're looking at 36-year-old Ed Beckley out of Dodge City, Kansas.
Big Ed Beckley, and Ed is considered to be the world's largest motorcycle jumper. Ed outweighs his motorcycle by 60 pounds, and that's a Harley Davidson. Ed is going to attempt to make a very long jump this evening, probably the equivalent to about 7 cars. Big Ed Beckley out of Dodge City, Kansas, and Ed's a professional at this. He's been at it for about 12 years, and he's done all sorts of long-distance jumps. And, you know, for quite some time, Ed jumped with his wife, Linda, on the back of him. Ed and Linda jumped together, and Linda now is at home with a new child, and Big Ed is doing it all by himself.
Well, Ed has crashed a few times. He said that he has had too many crashes to count. He said he's broken enough bones, and they're mended together with enough metal that when he sets off the detector at the airport going through.
Well, I want to tell you how big Ed is. It takes about 3 large cows to make the leathers for Ed Beckley. And he's one big man, world's largest motorcycle jumper. Watch him go to work. He's got quite a chore with him tonight. Big Ed Beckley. You know, he's lived in Kansas and Texas almost all of his life, and he's very much a professional. Made some very long jumps on this. But right now, tonight, riding a XR600 Harley-Davidson Special. It's an experimental, weighs 250 pounds, and as we mentioned earlier, that's a lot less than Big Ed Beckley weighs. Look at the star on the back of Big Ed. Here he goes. The big man out of Kansas is going to take his attempt. He'll be jumping the equivalent of about 7 cars tonight. He's got a very short takeoff area. He's going to make a bend and swing around and then come back and get a shot at the ramp. And the most critical point of any motorcycle jump is the lineup, like this one we're seeing right here. Ooh, and Ed decided we better wait just one more time. It's kind of testing the acceleration of the motorcycle, feeling it out, making sure that he's got plenty of throttle response. And, you know, when he leaves the ramp, he wants to have all the quickness of the throttle.
What did you say the most critical part of the jump was, other than the landing?
Other than the landings, when he comes around and makes his swing and lines up perfectly on that ramp. A big red arrow marks the direction and the lines that Big Ed wants to be on when he makes his attempt at the ramp. Now he's taking his first shot at it. He's lined up now. Let's see what happens. He's up. No, Big Ed didn't think it was quite right this time.
What is he exactly looking to do?
He wants the speed on the bike. The speed on the bike is very, very critical. You'd like to have the bike at about 48, 49 miles an hour when he hits the lower portion of the ramp. And right now, you know, he's making a swing, he's making a big circle, and then coming in for the straight shot onto the ramp. When he's doing this in his test run, you'll notice that he's looking down at the mile per hour gauge, speedometer, and looking to see if he can make it all the way over. Here he goes. Look out. He made it. He made it. What a jump. A tremendous, tremendous job for Big Ed Beckley.
That's quite a show.
It is quite a show. That's amazing that a man that weighs that many pounds can go over on such a small bike. Big Ed Beckley out of Dodge City, Kansas.
And he's happy, and so is the crowd here at the Metrodome in Minneapolis. Here's a replay.
Here's where Big Ed makes the swing. Now, he's looking down at the speedometer, got everything on go. He hits the ramp right there. All he can do is hold on and ride. There's the shower of fireworks. Big Ed almost overshot the runway. A good job, and all he's got to do now is get his hands on the brakes of that Harley and put it to a stop.
We'll be back with more on the Ford Budweiser. It's Hot Rod Association Motorsports Extravaganza after this. Here's Dave Billingsley out of White Bear Lake, Minnesota. Disorderly conduct. Cut tire competition, mud bog racing.
These are street tires that have been cut to the driver's specifications. Dave's the first man to go in a pit. It's a 700 horsepower Chevrolet motor, moves it right to the line. Here's one thing you want to watch on Dave. He actually will not run through the pit. He will run on top of the pit, or he hopes to run on top of the pit. He'll leave with it, runs nitrous oxide on it, he'll mash the button, the power goes in. Watch him go on top.
He's not on top, Mike.
He is not on top. He left, skipped about halfway, and just didn't have the power to go all the way through.
Here's Dan Zimet out of Shoreview, Minnesota in Kodiak.
This is a very good-looking late-model Jeep, stretch wheelbase on it, cut tires all the way around, and watch for the Kodiak vehicle to put some distance between he and the starting line, because this is one of the vehicles that you're going to see run consistently at the front of the class. Here's a young man that's not the first time in the pit for him. Look out! He's headed out! Look at that!
He did the full 90 feet!
We're talking quick! And there's a young man that's very, very excited, and I don't blame him. Take a look at the mud vehicle. He actually went through the pit so quick, the mud didn't land on the vehicle. He drove underneath the mud. He kicked it up in the air, went underneath it. There's a very fast vehicle called Kodiak.
Dan Zimet out of Shoreview, Minnesota.
Watch this hole shot as he leaves the starting line. Front end up in the air, all the traction in the world, and Kodiak is right on top of the mud, skipping the line fantastic as he goes right out the end of the 90-foot. A beautiful pass. We'll get a time on it. Of course, if you go all the way through, no getting stuck or stopping anywhere in the pit, it's a time situation. A great pass for Kodiak. Watch out!
That's Quagmire, driven by Tom Berg from North St. Paul.
What do you talk about? Quick! That young man just cut a trail that was unbelievable.
The Dan Zimet of Shoreview, along with Tom Berg of North St. Paul, have gone the full distance, and now we're into a time situation.
Had it just a little bit wild on the big end of the pit, but held control of it, shut it right out the gate, bounces a little bit on the end, but he retains full control of it and jumps on the brakes and shuts it down. A beautiful job. I mean, a tremendous job. Big horsepower coming out of that little lightweight mud racer.
Well, they're all freshly scrubbed and cleaned now. They're an interesting design, these mud racers. And before the competition, Mike Galloway took a look.
Thanks, Bob. This is the legend. 2,400 pounds of mud racer. Supercharged Chevrolet motor, stretch wheelbase. The ride is outstanding in this track. The mud is quick. The vehicle is quick. 1,500 horsepower, a stretch wheelbase. It should be really exciting. You sit down inside a roll cage. If anything was to happen, you've got all the protective mechanism to keep you in place. This should be one of the wildest rides here tonight. Two classes of mud racers on hand tonight. One of them's the tractor class, and the other is the 44 and under DOT tires, cut tires. They're the Department of Transportation recognized tires, but the guys have cut the tires in a design that they think will best suit their needs tonight. Now, this one's got the lugs cut out of it. Enables the tires to spin through the mud, but it clears the mud out of the tire each time the tire goes around. So when the tire comes around for the next time, the next traction, it's clear of the mud, the bite's there, and it goes quicker through the mud. You know, this is going to be one of the quickest mud racers in the class. Let's watch for him tonight.
This is the legend out of Cedar, Minnesota, driven by Mike Keeney.
This should be one quick racer. Supercharged, big block Chevrolet. This young man's probably pounding out about 1,700 horsepower out of this vehicle. It's an all fiberglass body, stretched wheelbase. He's got a run.
Well, he got off to a slow start and then just sunk in the mud.
One thing about it, just kind of from the shot we're looking at right there, he said nothing about the name of that vehicle on the path. Now, one thing to kind of watch when he left the starting line on that pass, watch the front tires as he leaves the starting line. They're turning, but right about there, they begin to let up a little bit. He's trying to do it all with the rear tires and trying to skip the top of the mud. Also, he's leaned out one side of the motor and has some problems and does nothing but plow him right into the middle of the pit.